Hi, I'm Garret, Towne with AM Solar, and today we're going to be talking about series and parallel solar panel connections. A series connection is when you have two or more panels connected positive to negative in a chain. In this orientation, the charge controller sees a voltage that is the sum of all the solar panels and a current that is the same as the current going through a single panel. If you had four 100 watt panels, each with a VMPP of 18 volts and an IMPP of 5.5 amps, your charge controller would see 5.5 amps at 72 volts. A parallel connection is where you have the positive leads from all the panels grouped together on one bus and all the negatives grouped on the other bus bar. In this orientation, the charge controller sees a voltage that is the same as that of a single panel, but the current sum. If you had four 100 watt panels, each with a VMPP of 18 volts and an IMPP of 5.5 amps, your charge controller would see 22 amps at 18 volts. When you have two panels in series connected in parallel to other pairs of series connected panels, you have what we call a series pair. In this orientation, you get a voltage of 2 times the voltage of an individual panel and a current equivalent to the number of pairs times the individual panel current. If you had four 100 watt panels, each with a VMPP of 18 volts and an IMPP of 5.5 amps, your charge controller would see 11 amps at 36 volts. Assuming no partial shade and cable thick enough to make line losses negligible, they all produce the same amount of power. Power sums based on the wattage rating of each panel, no matter how they are connected. If you had four 100 watt panels, each with a VMPP of 18 volts and an IMPP of 5.5 amps, you would have 400 watts. Since power equals volts times amps, 72 volts times 5.5 amps equals 400 watts, 18 volts times 22 amps equals 400 watts, and 36 volts times 11 amps also equals 400 watts. The main difference between the different types of connections has to do with line losses. Line losses are proportional to current, cable length, and cable thickness. If you have high current running through thin cables over a long distance, you're going to have higher line losses. A system with all the panels in series will have the highest voltage and lowest current. This means that the line losses will be very low, which means smaller cables can be used. Factory solar pre-wires usually have very cheap cable that is too small for large parallel connected arrays. In situations where we are forced to work with undersized cable, we use series connections. This is an example of a combiner box with parallel connections. You have positives all tied on this side and negatives on this side, leaving the combiner box with very thick cables going down to the charge controller. Factory pre-wires don't use as thick of cables as this. The current produced by a solar panel is proportional to the amount of sunlight hitting it. So right here in the sun, I'm gonna be producing pretty good current. As I walk into the shade, that current is gonna drop off. But the voltage remains the same because voltage is more of a function of temperature. The current produced by a solar panel is proportional to the amount of light hitting it. If a panel or even a cell is in the shade, it will operate at a low current. With series connected solar panels, all cells for that matter, operate at the same current. This means that shade on one cell has the potential to drop the production of the entire solar array. So with this solar panel, all the cells are connected in series. The series starts here, it goes down, up, and back down. And it uses half cells. So if you shaded just one of these half cells, it would knock out the production for the entire panel because it would force everything to operate at the current of that shaded cell. Bypass diodes in modern solar panels are able to isolate the underperforming panels or panel sections and allow current to go around the underperforming section. But in doing so, the voltage is reduced proportional to the contribution of the bypass section. Series connections are great when cables are undersized and can run with slightly more efficiency on MPPT charge controllers, but they don't perform as well in partial shade conditions, especially if the panels don't have functioning bypass diodes. Series connections also result in higher voltage and may not be compatible with your charge controller and may introduce safety concerns due to the increased likelihood of arcing. Parallel connections are the preferred method as long as you use an adequately sized cable between the solar array and the charge controller. If one panel is shaded, it just contributes less current to the combiner box, but does not bring down the performance of any other panels in the array. Series pairs allow undersized cables to be used and basically have the benefits of parallel connected solar arrays in terms of partial shade resilience. It gets a little complicated when one panel in a series pair is shaded and the others aren't, because that will result in the half voltage being fed to the combiner box, which brings down the performance of the other panels in the connection. If you need help configuring your array or selecting the correct cable size, feel free to contact AM Solar. Thank you for watching.
There we go.